Good morning students. I hope the last video is clear, and if you have any doubts, feel free to ask the doubts. Today I am going to explain you about the structural organization of a cell. If you observe the cells carefully under the microscope, you will find three features are common in almost all the cells. What are those three features? In that first, you will find plasma membrane or cell membrane. Second, nucleus. Third, cytoplasm. These three features are common in almost all the cells. And in this chapter, you are going to learn about these three in a detailed manner. Coming to first, plasma membrane. Plasma membrane or cell membrane is the outermost covering of the animal cell. It acts as a protective covering and it allows the entry and exit of some materials in and out of the cell. It allows only the good materials to come inside the cell. And if the materials are harmful, this plasma membrane will not allow them to come into the cell. That is the reason it is called as selectively permeable membrane. So, you can call cell membrane as plasma membrane or selectively permeable membrane. And what is the function of this plasma membrane? Some substances like carbon dioxide and oxygen can move across cell membrane through a process called diffusion. So what is diffusion? Diffusion means the movement of substances from the region of high concentration to the region of low concentration. For example, even in our body also the diffusion process occurs. Some substances like carbon dioxide, which is a cellular waste given out by our cells, accumulates in high concentration inside the cell than outside the cell. So the carbon dioxide moves out of a cell from the region of high concentration to a region of low concentration. In a similar manner, oxygen also enters the cell by diffusion when the level of oxygen decreases inside the cell. What about the movement of water? Water obeys the law of osmosis. What is osmosis? The movement of water from the region of high concentration to the region of low concentration is called as osmosis. So what is the difference between diffusion and osmosis? Diffusion means the movement of gases from the region of high concentration to low concentration. Osmosis means the movement of water from the region of high concentration to the region of low concentration. Next, we are performing a simple activity. What happens when we put a cell, it may be a plant cell or animal cell, in hypotonic solution, isotonic solution and hypertonic solution? So coming to first, hypotonic solution. To make hypotonic solution, first you need to take a beaker, fill the beaker with water and put an animal cell. Now the beaker contains high amount of water when compared with the cell. The beaker contains high amount of water and the cell contains low concentration of water. So the water from the beaker slowly starts moving into the cell, because of which the cell starts swelling in its size. This solution is called as hypotonic solution, and the water obeys the law of osmosis. Means the water is moving from higher concentration region to lower concentration region. because of which the cell swells up in its size. And coming to isotonic solution. To prepare isotonic solution, take a beaker filled with water and add very little amount of salt, because the cell also contain little amount of salt in it. And now put an animal cell in the beaker with water. Now both the medium has exactly the same water concentration as the cell. Water crosses the cell membrane in both direction, but the amount going in is the same as the amount going out. So the cell will remain in the same size. This is isotonic solution. The cell will not swell or it will not shrink. It will remain in the same size. And coming to hypertonic solution. To prepare hypertonic solution, take a beaker filled with concentrated solution. So what is the meaning of concentrated solution? If you add high amount of salt or sugar to the water, then we will call it as concentrated solution. In the concentrated solution, the water concentration will be very, very low. Why? Because the water molecules are occupied by the sugar. The space which is present in between the water molecules is completely occupied by the sugar or salt. So the concentration of water will be very, very less. And now put an animal cell into the beaker which contains concentrated solution. And now, as the cell contains high amount of water than the beaker, so slowly the water from the cell will start coming out. It moves into the beaker. So because of the loss of water inside the cell will start shrinking in its size. So coming to hypertonic solution, the cell will lose the water and it starts shrinking in its size. Okay, so osmosis is helpful in the movement of water, and diffusion is helpful in exchange of gases. And one more important point, the plasma membrane is made up of proteins and lipids. And next, what is endocytosis? The flexibility of the cell membrane to trap the food and other materials from the external environment is known as endocytosis. Example is amoeba. So the amoeba will show the flexibility of the cell membrane to trap the food particles and engulf. Engulf means it will intake into them. That process is called as endocytosis. This is the information regarding the plasma membrane or cell membrane. And coming to the next topic, cell wall. So what is a cell wall? Plant cells, in addition to plasma membrane, they have another hard outer covering called the cell wall. So the cell wall is found as the outer protective covering of the plant cell. For the plant cell, you will find the cell wall and cell membrane, both are present. And coming to animal cell, we have only cell membrane as the outer covering. And the cell wall is made up of cellulose. And what is the function of the cell wall? It provides structural strength to plants. It gives the mechanical strength to the plants. And when a living cell loses water through osmosis, what happens when a cell loses the water? The cell starts shrinking in its size. This phenomenon is called as plasmolysis. So what is plasmolysis? The shrinking of a cell due to loss of water is called as plasmolysis. Okay, and The cell wall permits the cells of the plants, fungi and bacteria to withstand very dilute external media without breaking. Means it acts as a hard protective covering. Even some of the examples were the cell wall. Cell wall is found in the plants, not only plants, in fungi and some kind of bacteria. Okay? And this is the, up to now you have learnt regarding the plasma membrane or cell membrane and cell wall. And coming to the next main topic, nucleus. So what is nucleus? Nucleus is called as the control center of a cell. If coming to animal cell, if you observe the animal cell carefully, in the animal cell, in the center you will find the nucleus, and in the plant cell you will find the nucleus is present at the corner, because in the plant cell the major space is occupied by the vacuoles. So what is the function of the nucleus? Coming to the internal structure first, nucleus is a double layered covering. It has a double layered covering, which we will call it as a nuclear membrane. Means the nucleus is covered by nuclear membrane. And through the nucleus also the exchange of materials takes place. Means the substances from the cytoplasm comes into the nucleus, and the materials from the nucleus, it will go into the cytoplasm. And if we observe the nucleus under the microscope, you will find long thread-like structures called chromatin. During the cell division, when a cell is going to divide, the chromatin will change into long rod-like structures called chromosomes. This is very important. What is the difference between chromatin and chromosomes? When you will observe a normal cell under the microscope, you will find long thread-like structures called as chromatin. But when you will observe that when a cell is going to divide, at that time the chromatin will only change into long rod-like structures called as chromosomes. So what are chromosomes? Chromosomes contain information for transfer of characters from parents to the next generation in the form of DNA. Means inside the chromosomes you will find the hereditary material, that is DNA, which will be transferred from the parents to their children. And what is the other function of the nucleus? The nucleus is helpful in the process of cell division. In our body, time to time the cell will undergo the cell division process. The nucleus is helpful in carrying out this cell division process, and along with that it is directing the chemical activities of a cell. So it is called as the control center of the cell. And today I have completed the topic up to the page number 62. If you have any doubts, feel free to ask the doubts, and in the next session I will start the topic cytoplasm.